So this is a little bit of a showcase on how all of my systems work. So we have the player controller here. We're gonna turn him on just so we can showcase how this guy works. Here's a movement system. I'm not going over this. This is very complicated. We don't talk about this. Here's the interaction controller. This is hooked up to a UI panel. Basically, he shoots out a ray cast. So whenever he looks at an object that has, or whenever the ray that comes out of his head, it's like a little line, it's an invisible line, hits an object with an interactable layer, which is just how you, it's like a tag for an object, it's like a category. And there's an interaction script on it that interaction activates, basically. So if we go to the player, that's what this does. The ray distance, this is how far he can interact with something. The input handler is just, WX or WASD. And then there's an ambience controller on him that plays random clips of audio, so it's like music. Basically, whatever, how you can put as many clips in here as you want, and it'll just play randomly after one finishes. You can press should continue, and it'll just play one audio. I don't know, that's probably just for like another. Like, if I wanted to turn it off with a script, I could. Basically, that's what that does. The camera holder, here's the camera controller. By default, this is hooked up to 600 just because that's the way I have my thing set up is really weird. There's an FOV setting and whatnot, camera sway, yada yada yada. There's also on the camera, there is a camera breathing script, XYZ. It's just if you don't move, I think I can actually show that off. Let me disable the player real quick. It's like a little breathing effect. So if you don't move, let's have this come on real quick. If you don't move, let me see if I don't move. You see how he's like going up and down, like the camera's just rotating a bit? That's what a camera breathing script is. It's pretty interesting. So player, that's awesome. So we also have a dialogue controller. The dialogue controller was that little thing that you saw a second ago on the bottom of the screen. This can be called from any object. This is codable. So inside of this script, let's open it real quick. There is a change dialogue option that just has a type text effect and whatnot. Pretty self-explanatory. This is the speed at what text types. This gets changed by if you called this from a script to change the dialogue. This will get changed. So this is just, yeah. Here's the player voice. This is where audio gets played to. So the dialogue, this is another audio source. There's nothing on it. I'm actually going to make this SFX because that would make sense. I forgot to do that a while ago. And then inside of the player, there's also a flashlight script that just shoots out a little light that comes out of him. It's not on right now because it's off by default, but that's what that does. And then the intro cutscene is just a timeline with objects on it that gets set active after it's over. It's just a little script that I wrote to set objects active, set active behavior. It just goes on. So if we go to this guy and we, where the fuck? Oh yeah, I need to disable some things real fast because I turned them back on. This needs to go off by default. That's that. I'll show off the door interaction right now because that's pretty cool. Let's let this cutscene play. So here's the dialogue system, like I said, the thing on the bottom, the press to use a flashlight. There's also an objective controller. It's the same thought process as the dialogue controller, just on the top left of the screen. So I'm gonna go to the door. As you can see, open door.
Is anyone there?
This is an example of it playing dialogue. That's all it really does, though. That one's kind of. I need to add. No, I don't. Never mind. I thought I didn't. Oh, yeah. I need to add mesh colliders for those guys. Otherwise, I'll just go right through them. We're gonna walk over to the new part that I'm working on to show off the rest of the door. And, like, here's a dialogue trigger. So this is something else that's not related to the door interaction. This is just a trigger to play dialogue. So that trigger right there
What the
plays a
hell?
sound, and it also toggles dialogue after a couple seconds. There's a little audio source right there that goes off whenever you step on this trigger. You can't see it, it's invisible, obviously. Ignore those. There's a little light flicker script that I made that only plays for a couple of seconds that just goes on and flicks that light right there. If we open the door, it has a little door creak. This is another door interaction, but it doesn't have anything on it other than... Yeah. I need to add a mesh collider on some of these objects, but I've made a bunch of models a little bit ago to fill up rooms that need to be adjusted accordingly. I don't know if this thing has a door. No, it doesn't. Okay. Here's the pause menu. The pause menu has another controller as well. We'll stop playing the game. The pause menu has a controller within controllers. So the pause menu script basically just has a couple of functions that get called on the buttons. Within the pause menu, there is a slider under the settings. This is the sensitivity controller. So this changes the camera sensitivity with another script. It changes the player sensitivity with the internal script, basically. I didn't show off the dialogue controller, the objective system. It's just has some links to the UI on the screen, basically. Barriers, these are just little invisible barriers. If I highlight them all, you can't go through these. They just kind of make up the map as it is right now. So let me turn the light off real fast. Let me close all this. We don't need all this open. I'm gonna turn on the actual dark lighting and turn this one off. There we go. I'll do a little bake real quick to make sure the shadows get made. If it'll hurry up and do that. We're gonna go to my main menu scene in a second. Once this is now, we'll just go now. It doesn't really matter. We're gonna save our settings in here. So, how the main menu works, if I go down to the scene here, there's a little camera. This guy has a little animation that just loops over and over again of him breathing. It's a little breathing animation. Inside the main menu, there's a main menu controller. Whenever you click the play button, whatever scene is indexed here gets loaded. So this is scene introduction 1. Under the build settings of the project, scene 1 is introduction. That's the next scene. There's a little fake delay so the loading screen doesn't go instantly, just to add some more. Yeah, whatever. Make it look cooler, I guess. The settings, basically, whenever you click on the settings button, it just toggles the settings menu active and it disables the main menu, like this right here. Disables this and activates this. And if you click back, it does the opposite. You know, as you can see it in the hierarchy, toggling on and off. The credits menu is the same way. Exit just calls application.quit, which you can't call on unless you have the game built. If you click play, it loads our little loading scene. And it starts introduction 1. This is the next scene. This scene works with another timeline right here. Once this is done running, it calls a scene loader that I made. This scene loader then calls a another scene to load. It causes introduction 2, which is the cutscene of the car crash. I thought it would be better if I just made them two different scenes because it makes everything more organized, basically. These are just a little animations, and then here's scene 2.
This place is fucking creepy.
This also has a timeline, as you can see right here.
Ah, shit!
With little audio sounds, and then it loads the actual level after a couple seconds. Here's the car crash scene. This is where we just were. And then we're in the actual game now. For the most part, I'm still working on gameplay and stuff. You know, pretty yada yada yada, but that's basically the background behind everything. It's pretty easy to grasp your head behind how everything works. But that is that, so, yep. Yeah.